to Wednesday morning in the middle of our week, as usual, and we are delighted to be here together to share these few moments of reflection, a few moments of peace as we prepare to go into our week and to allow God to guide us through this time. It is truly a delight to be with you, and I trust that as we share in this time that you will find some measure of inner peace and hope and even expansion, that the light that is within you may shine even more brightly. Join me now as we go into our time of meditation. The light of Christ surrounds us. The love of Christ enfolds us. The power of Christ protects us. The presence of Christ watches over us. Wherever we are, God is. As we come into our hearts and breathe intentionally into our hearts, we bring into our hearts that sense of gratitude and love. As we hold there that true awareness of God's presence, of God's love, of God's peace. In our pustinia, our secret place, closed off from all other external stimuli, we turn our intention inward. And we seek God in the depth of our being, knowing that it is there that God speaks with us and relates to us, in that inner chamber, in secret. Allow yourself to feel that sense of peace. And allow that sense of peace to pervade the entire body. Little by little, just feel that sense of peace radiating from within your heart. And go into every part of your body. And in our hearts, we offer a word of prayer. And make it this day a word. Just one word. Let one word be your prayer. Whatever word rises up within you this day, let that be your prayer. And just for the next few moments, just repeat it constantly. And with each repetition, just feel as though it's going deeper and deeper and deeper. Until it is almost so deep that you can hardly hear the word or sense it, but it becomes like a part of you. And you are now the word, and the word is you. It is no longer an object, but it is you. You are that word. Today you are that word to the world. We turn to our gospel reading from Mark. And he cautioned them, the Pharisees came and began to argue with Jesus, asking him for a sign from heaven to test him. And he sighed deeply in his spirit and said, why does this generation ask for a sign? Truly, I tell you, no sign will be given to this generation. And he left them, and getting into the boat again, he went across to the other side. Now the disciples had forgotten to bring any bread, and they had only one loaf with them in the boat. And he cautioned them, saying, watch out. Beware of the yeast of the Pharisees and the yeast of Herod. They said to one another, it is because we have no bread. And becoming aware of it, Jesus said to them, why are you talking about having no bread? Do you still not perceive or understand? Are your hearts hardened? Do you have eyes and fail to see? Do you have ears and fail to hear? Do you have eyes and fail to see? Do you have ears and fail to hear? And do you not remember when I broke the 5 loaves for the 5,000? How many baskets full of broken pieces did you collect? They said to him, 12. And the 7 for the 4,000? How many baskets full of broken pieces did you collect? And they said to him, 7. Then he said to them, do you not yet understand? This is the word of the Lord.
Oh, what peace we have.
eyes, ears, listen on the surface, not going deeper. Not really embracing fully the message. Such was the experience of the disciples prior to the day of Pentecost. They seemed at times lost, not sure of what Jesus was saying or doing. But even though we may point at them and indicate that they might have been lost at times, well, they only had Jesus, and this was all new. We've had Jesus, we've had them, we've had other saints, we've had many men and women of faith. But in some regards, we still listen and see on the surface and not from a deeper place. The invitation always is to go deeper, to take our time and to allow the word to sink deep into our hearts, to come to a deeper understanding of what this journey is about, to take the words that we hear and move them from the surface and allow them to ruminate in our hearts, in the deep places of our hearts, and to see what new message God is bringing to us. Much of faith and faith experience tends to be very surface, and it is because it's not easy to stay in the depth unless one is able to engage in a significant practice. But life is so busy for us. At least we use that as our reason for not going deep. That life is so busy for us that we don't have time to go deep. And if we go deep, as soon as we're finish, we have to spring back into our daily lives. Many of you might be listening to this as you drive or as you are getting ready. Some might have sat and listened, but knowing that at a certain time you have to jump up and begin to get ready. And so we oftentimes don't have that luxury, as it were, to sit with and to be, and to allow ourselves to gradually sink deeper and deeper into our reflection. And so while we receive some gems from our moments of deepening, there's so much more that we lose out of. There's so much more that we lose out on because we are not able to really go deep and stay deep for an extended time. Hence why there are things like retreats and vision quests for persons to go deep and not be distracted by anything else. Lent is intended to be one of those times, but few of us can afford to give up everything and just go into Lent. So even in this time, we are still challenged by the inability that we find ourselves constantly in. The inability to go deep and to stay deep for an extended time. But be that as it may, whatever we can afford, whatever we can accomplish, I want to encourage us to do so. To grab the time when we can and to go deep. Even if it's for a few moments. Try to steal a few moments here and there in your journey, in your day. And just allow yourself to go down. Jesus' disciples totally misunderstood what he was talking about. He was referring to the challenges that he faced in having to help the authorities of the day to really come to grips with what's really going on. And they kept asking for superficialities. They wanted a sign here. They wanted him to show this. They wanted him to answer that. And so Jesus was saying, listen, beware. Beware of the so-called yeast of these who lead you. There's not much there. There's not much worth in that yeast. It doesn't serve the purpose. The disciples misunderstood and thought that he was referring to the fact that they didn't have any bread with him. After all, they had only recently fed the 5,000 and the 4,000. Jesus reminds them, why would I be asking for bread? What do we do in those last occasions? You see, you forget. Because it's just an event. It's just something that happened. And we move forward looking for the next event. For the next occurrence. As opposed to using the occurrences that we've had, the experiences that we've had to go deep and to let them sink in, and let's milk them for all that we can, because there's so much more that is there for us. So as we find ourselves on this Wednesday morning, I want to encourage us to not be like the disciples, but to gather all your experiences of God's activity in your life, to gather it up, and to reflect, and to go deep on each one, and see what God has been showing you in the recent months. I believe you will be surprised at what gems you've received.